Vagi sajasya badane Lakshmir yasya cha bakshasi Yasya asti hide sambhit Pam nishingam aham bhaji Pasya nisam jagadidam Khanabhangunishtam Vairagurasiko Bhavabhoktinishto Pasya nisam jagadidam Khanabhangunishtam Vairagurasiko Bhavabhoktinishto Asar khalu sangsaru Dukshuru pibimakaha Shutaha kasya jharam kasya Snehovan jalati anisham Gauriya Goshtipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told for very cheap kam, for very very cheap kama, those common people going to sacrifice their life. Very dangerous. For very, very cheap karma, they are going to sacrifice their life. That is the tragedy. Very dangerous situation in this material world. You can try to think over and again about the sloka I already, you know, speaking. Is by Gokarnaji Maharaj. Gokarnaji Maharaj speaking in front of Atmadevji, father, who is in bonded condition, very painful condition. He is speaking, when father wants to get rescue from this very painful situation, very, very painful situation, now he like to get rescue. And he is going to put some question in front of Gokarnaji Maharaj, who is Mahabhagavat. Brahmando bhamita kono bhagyavan jeev guru krishna prasade pai bhakti lata bij. Now he want to ask some question in front of Gokarnaji Maharaj. He is speaking, what the situation I am put into? Asara sangsara khalu dukshrupi vimokaha sutaha kasya dhanam kasya snehovana jalate anisham. Gokarnaji Maharaj speaking, who is your wife? Who is your children? Who, what is this material world? You try to think over and again. Asaro khalu sangsaro dukshrupi vimokaha. Asaro sangsa, asaro khalu sangsaro dukshrupi vimokaha. This sangsar, this material world, going to give pain repeatedly, going to give pain, full of misery. It's an ocean of misery. Somebody asking me, Maharaj, what is the definition of sangsar? I say, Maharaj, definition of sangsar, if you like to know, then I can say this much, that you can pull whole problem of this world in one place, garbage. This is called sangsar. Follow? What is sangsar? It's called sangsar. So, asaharo khalu sangsaro dukshrupi vimokaha sutaha kasya dhanam kasya snehovan jalati anisham. Pasya nisam jagadidam khanabhangunishtam vairagurasiko bhavabhoktinishto. Pasya nisam jagadidam khanabhangunishtam. In every fraction of second you will have to watch. In every fraction of second you will have to watch that this material world is changeable. Every fraction of second changing. Pasyani sanjagadin khanabhangunishtam is very temporary. Prabhupada speaking, nothing in this material world is permanent. All your bank money, all your security, deposit, any kind of measure you are going to take to give a nice safeguard to your life, but all uncertain. Everything uncertain, there is no stability of life. Any moment you can die. Just 2 days before, one nice devotee driving car, Padmanabha Prabhu, meet with an accident, living body. We cannot expect this kind of death. But what to do? It's a must. There is a life. So actually, Gokarnaji Maharaj speaking in front of Atmajivji, Pasya Nisam, Anisham, every fraction of second you try to see, try to watch that this whole world is changeable. There's some changing and all temporary, nothing permanent. You can remember yesterday I was thinking about very vital point that this mind is the main cause of your bondage and freedom. This mind, this your material mind, is the cause of your bondage and freedom. Nothing else. Same mind, if you are going to engage in Hari Bhajan, Sadhu Guru Vaishnav Seva, good association, this mind can change and you can find a scope to do Hari Bhajan. Ultimately, you can get a scope to go to transcendental world or Prakrit Jagat. No other way. No other way open. So, satsanga is a must. Through satsanga, we can change our life, go to Supreme Lord. Change your mind means first you will have to change your mind. First, you will have to change your mind. But mind is very dangerous, I already told. Always everybody thinking how to get control over their material mind. It is just next to impossible. It is just next to impossible, but still possible. Still possible. That's why Arjuna putting question in front of Krishna, I already discussed this point. Atho kena prayuktayam papan charati purushaha. Atho kena prayuktayam papan charati purushaha. Anichanno pibalsiyo baladipo niyajitaha. Is not willingly, you know, going to make any mistake, but somehow he is bound to make mistake, papa. What is the basic reason behind it? Who is as if some unknown source going to put pressure on that jivatma to commit some papa or parada? What is the reason? Bhagavan Sri Krishna already given advice that see Arjuna, kama esha, krodha esha, raja guna samadbhavaha, mahasana mahapatna, Vidhinam enam bairinam. Kama esha krodha esha rajo guno samadbhavaha mahasana mahapapna vidhinam enam bairinam. All your kama, different kind of desire, kama esha krodha, krodha, angry attitude, kama esha krodha eva, krodha esha rajo guno samadbhavaha. They have all spring up from rajagun to give you inspiration to do this, commit this pap, opera, this way you are doing. And try to know that this is your enemy, number one enemy in your life. Now, yesterday, that Mataji also put it one question in front of me. we like to know something special about this mind, but mind. Man, buddhi, chitto, ahankar. Man, buddhi, chitto, ahankar. Man, mind, chitta, intellect, and ahankar, false ego. All constituent of your fine body. Is the same antakaran, same antakaran, but due to different functions, there are different name I am bound to speak. Follow? Now actually point is that mind is like ether. Ether, you know? Space. When in the space, if you look at space, you can find all stars and moon, sun, sun god, everything there. Who holding, who knows? Nityananda Balaram Anantadev holding, but nobody knows. A suspended condition there in the sky, in space. So many countless stars and planets. So our Guru Bhargava giving us example, your mind, if you look at sky, you can find countless things there. Similarly, your mind is like ether, space, in which all matters can stay in fine form. Follow? Matter is not there, but can be, matter can be there in fine form. Follow? Follow what I say. Matter is not there, but in fine form, possibility there. So in fine form, everything there. Externally, want to prove I am Vairagya, I am detachment growing. But inside mind, you have all attachment and everything for material things. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, this kind of thing is very dangerous. Because if externally you are going to show detachment, but internally if you have attachment, it is very dangerous. It is called very dangerous thing. It is called very dangerous. Internally, kama, krodha. Internally, kama, krodha, everything there. Externally, you want to show that I am free from everything. It is mithacharu sauchyate. It's called mithachar. You are going to take the help of on of falsity. It's not mithacharu sauchyate. Better you try to show what you are exactly. It's good. Because antare vahire samabhavahar amani manodhavo is first point. Internally and externally, your heart should be parallel. Antara bahire samabhavahar mean your heart should be parallel. No, there should not be any kind of duplicity. Also, yesterday I was discussing some point about any function, any asasanga you are doing, you are going to get bad result. But maybe in the name of satsanga, you are going to get asasanga. Who can say? In the name of satsanga, suppose you are going to get asasanga. In that case, what you can do? In that case, that's why I told you, only we have to pray cravingly. To the Supreme Lord, Guru Vaishnava, they can help us to cut all the different kind of dangers coming in our life. Especially when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to South India, you can remember, Sakshat Paratpara Akhileshwar Bhagavan Sri Krishna, when going to South India, in that case Mahaprabhu when started, then they are shouting, Rama Raghava Rama Raghava Rama Raghava Rakshamam Krishna Kesava Krishna Kesava Krishna Kesava Pahimam. Why? He is Supreme Lord. He is Supreme Lord. But still he is going to shout this way, Rama Raghava Rama Raghava Rama Raghava Rakshamam Krishna Kesava Krishna Kesava Krishna Kesava Pahimam. Why? Pahimam means rescue me. What is the reason? Supreme Lord also teaching us this way we have to pray, because asasanga is so dangerous. Maybe you don't know, in fine form asasanga can come. Externally you cannot find. That's why in Mahaprabhu going to South India, especially there is Mayavad belt, you know, Mayavad belt, especially Mayavad belt. That's why Mahaprabhu teaching us this way we have to pray. Follow? When those who are going to foreign country, I don't know what is the situation, but I know the heart of Swami Maharaj. I know the heart of Siddhar Goswami Maharaj. They teach me. Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, one Prabhupada took decision to send him. Sridhar Maharaj would, I don't like to go. Foreign country, what to do? Then after that, Prabhupada changed decision. But I'm saved. Prabhupada wanted to send me to foreign country, but internally I was not ready yet because I want to go dangerous place. But after that, Prabhupada gone. Prabhupada allowed me to do foreign preaching, sitting here in, where in? Kolodip. Same target I have. Follow. He's saying, Prabhupada doing foreign preaching through me, but sitting here is more nice. So this way actually Sridhar Maharaj and where took decision to send Hayagri Brahmachari to foreign country, all senior devotees, Maharaj is so nice looking. Ajahn Maharaj, very dangerous. After that, Prabhupada stopped. Should not stop, send him. This way actually, Prabhupada taking right decision, Prabhupada giving power to everybody, not that. Anyway, foreign preaching, actually those who are going to foreign preaching, each and every time, the Swami Maharaj, everybody, honestly, Ito, Nishingo, all the time, praying. All the time, because no, any kind of asasanga can come in my life. Though they are elevated, oh no, asasanga cannot do anything, but still, by the mercy of Prabhupada, they are going. By the mercy of Prabhupada, they are going. So, less possibility, but still. So, asasanga can come in fine form, especially when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to South India, praying this way and to the lotus feet, Ramchandra, Rama, Raghava, Rama, this way. Why? Because this is Mayavad field. So Mayavad devotee all every time you can feel. Mayavad devotee all everywhere. Most of them Mayavadi and some of them Ramanuja Sampradaya, some Madhacharya Sampradaya, some Nimbarka, but most of them Mayavadis. Very dangerous. When I usually go to Haridwar, they call me for preaching Harikatha. When I go through road all around Mayavadi. But mentally I close eyes and see the lotus feet of Gurudeva to purify me. Because I have no scope to go to Ganga to take bath. Where Mahaprabhu told, if you see one Mayavadi, you will have to take bath with your cloth. With your cloth itself, you have to take bath to purify. So it's very dangerous. So it's not a matter of joke to purify yourself. To purify yourself, how to purify? We just cannot cross the boat. So dangerous. How I protect myself? Dangerous. So how they protect? In flight, I cannot check myself. How to? Oh, very dangerous. Yes. So contamination, everybody. So every time, very dangerous. Asasanga, all the time. So you see, but if you want to avoid asasanga externally, but still there is a possibility that you can get asasanga in fine form. So our Guru Varga giving us conception that in fine form, like matters are not there inside your matters are not there externally, but inside your mind there can be some matters. Attraction and different kind of objects can be there. Your building, your property, your wife, your husband, everything can be there in fine form. So you cannot avoid it. Also, yesterday I told you how to calculate. Because every day you will have to calculate. Today you are going ahead or coming back. Every day you have to do some calculation. Because any kind of function you are going to attend, any kind of yagya, any kind of yagya you are doing, karma yagya, gyan yagya, some sort of, but our bhakti yagya. But those who are not situated in totally bhakti, anyway they are going to do something, it is some kind of karma yagya, maybe if they are going to offer it for Krishna. Though our bhakti yagya, but still all, everybody cannot understand bhakti yoga. It's very, very fine thing. So, actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving explanation of the sloka. Sreyanudubhumyad jagyad gyanajagya parantapaha sarvan karmana khilam partho gyane parishamapate. In Gita, Bhagavan Sri Krishna was speaking to Arjuna that Sriyana Durbhumaya Jagyad Gyana Jagyam Parantapaha. All Sriyana Durbhumaya Jagyad, Durbhumaya Yajna, you are going to do some Durbhumaya Yajna. Durbhumaya Yajna is the matters, oriented matters. You are going to some Yajna, oriented matters, Durbhumaya Yajna. But from Durbhumaya Yajna, Gyan Yajna is more high. Because even if you are going to do some karma yajna, finally, what is the outcome? Because that karma yajna, if it is accurate, then going to give you some conception of knowledge, gyan. Follow? And that gyan, very mature form, when gyana, in more mature form, very nice, like mango, when totally ripe in trees, very sweet. That's why when Gyan is more, ripe and ripe, more ripe, very sweet. In that case, our Guru Bhargava teaches us in definition that when Gyan is totally in matured form, it is equal to bhakti. Gyan, ultimately in very, very matured form, very fine form, accurate, matured form, totally ripe, it is called bhakti. Is you can see. So, Sriyano Dribbhumaya Jagyad Gyana Yajyam Parantapaha. So, Dribbhumaya from Dribbhumaya Jagya, Gyana Yajyam far better. And why? Basaravana Karmana Khilam Partho Gyane Parishamapate. Ultimately, you are going to get everything in the form of Gyana. But ultimately, that Gyana, when ripe totally, then it becomes bhakti. Follow what I say. Now I want to give you one example, nice example, so that you can understand why Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Suppose there is one yajna. Sometime in our temple, yajna going on, Nisinga yajna, this, that. But be careful, one point I'm going to speak. Yajna going on, and those Ramanandi Sampada, they are all Durbhumaya yajna. They are going to distribute prasadam to anybody coming. Ramanandi Sampada is also one Durbhumaya yajna. I can explain this point. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, any kind of yajna you are doing, some matters oriented, even if you are going to worship Supreme Lord, follow, try to follow me. Suppose you are going to worship Supreme Lord, for that you need so many things, flowers, fruits, everything, asan, dupa, deepa, everything, you will have to arrange everything. All. After that, you will have to sit in asana, purify asana. Om asana mantra sameru pishto rising chutulam chanda kurma devata asarom pivishana vinyaka. After that, you can purify yourself. Apavitta, apavitta, sarva vastakata viyasadun punirkakam sabajyamantaram suchi. After that, you will have to bhuta shuddhi. After that, you can sit in asana doing achaman and start archan. In Bhajan Rahasa preface, Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada speaking, that in Archan Paddhati also, you need to take help of some matters. Without that, not possible. You are going to offer some fruits and flowers. I have seen myself. Those who are flower men going to, sell flower, I say they are going to pass urine. Without anything, they are going to take flower going. I have seen the Muslim, vendor selling fruits. He is going to take apple. He is going to take khaini and that of you going to give you apple or fruits. This way, if you think nothing in this material world at present is, you cannot find purity. Milk you go, you can see. They are sleeping at night, the young batch, everybody. Gosha. They are sleeping night. Daytime they pass urine, this and they're gone. They're not going to take bath. They have no conception that this milk they are going to offer to Krishna temple. No, they're going. This way, nothing in this material world you can find which you can think it is totally purified. It's not possible. So actually, when you are going to do archan, in archan also some matters involved, you have to offer flowers and fruits, everything. But in this archan procedure, Prabhupada speaking, some matters are also oriented. So archan is such a procedure where you will have to unify both procedures. One is you are in a bonded condition, you are trying to reach that spiritual level. So some spiritual contact and some matters also combined here. Finally, those who are elevated devotees, when they are doing archan, it is not at all ordinary archan. It is not at all ordinary archan like those who are, Kanishtha Adhikari doing. Even they are not Kanishtha Adhikari, they are doing archan. For Kanishtha Adhikari, archan is safe because through archan they can try to purify. Anyway, if you are acting as pujari, you will have to maintain purity. At present, what they are doing, I don't know. Previously, I was in Dauji Mandir Vrindavan, somehow pujari fly, stealing something, open mane and gone, flying. Then after that, who can do archan? I am doing part, this, that. But the temple committee giving requesting me, you can start archan. I say, actually, if Guru Maharaj is going to speak me, then I can start archan. So they connect me over telephone. Guru Maharaj speaking, Baba, you try to do archan. It is my blessing that you can discover what kind of kripa you are going to get from Dauji. I say, Maharaj, which mantra? Because all other mantra I know how much. Dauji mantra, how to do? Then Guru Maharaj over telephone, give me mantra. Then I started worshipping. Really so? By worshipping Dauji, I am totally benefited. His guru. And when I used to worship Dauji, I think one small boy is sitting, standing. Never I think it is deity. Never I thought he is deity. I used to treat him that way. A small boy standing on the altar. And speaking with him, doing everything like that, like mad. But really so. Dauji Maharaj is so merciful. So archan is possible, 100%. The reason for why I wanted to speak this point, that I know the purity of Guru Maharaj. I know the purity of Maharaj, Guru Maharaj. So I was very afraid. All the time I am trying to maintain purity, though I am not pure inside. But as far the desire of Guru Maharaj, I am trying. So then I was very careful. Suppose I am getting up 2:30 or 3 o'clock. Vrindavan, 2:30, 3 o'clock, too much. Very winter season, taking bath in cold water, 5 degrees, 6 degrees. Now at present, I don't know. That time, one time it happened so, all Delhi pipeline all broken. Because 4 degrees reach. 4 degree density of water is maximum. 4 degree. Then all broken, pipeline. This way. Voilà. So still, if I think it necessary to go to bathroom because some problem have maybe, then in that case again unencumbering everything over. So 5:30 I would have to do aarti, after that archan. Then again I take bath, again do tilak again. Again, full bath. No excuse. Then after that enter temple, do everything this way. Everything this way, hard life. So I know the purity of Guru Maharaj. Guru Maharaj used to do archan in Jogabirsi Mandir. At the time of Bhaktivilas Chitta Goswami, he was in charge of Jogfit, writing so many things at the same time, archan. I heard from senior devotees, you don't know the purity of Guru Maharaj. When Guru Maharaj, you are going to Lagusankha, you know? Foolish number one. Vaishnav. Lagusankha means you are going to pass urine. It's called Lagusankha. Guru Sankha means very fair word. In Sadhu Samaj we used to, in Vaishnav Samaj we used to use this word. Very nice. Lagusankha. Then you Guru Maharaj change all clothes with gamcha going after passing, then take bath up to, then again Ashaman, take bath, then oh my God. This is a purity. Now what I mean to say, for archan also, you will have to get some scope of combination. Some your heart is like to touch the transcendental chidvastu through butsuddhi, everything, but still matters are there, you will have to purify. So in Kalikal, specially, Sankirtan Jagga is favorable. Why? No, nothing you can find pure. Some are different kind of, you know, impurity there. So it's good that if you can do Naam Sankirtan. Sankirtan Naam is, you know, Kalikal is favorable because nobody can. But still, I like to explain this point, Prabhupada speaking. In archan procedure also some matters and your spiritual, effort or involved, and gradually if you go on practicing archan, someday you can have the chance to do Harinam. Harinam, you know, Jeno Janma Satair Purvam Vasudeva Samarchitam Tanmukhe Harinamani Tishtati Bharataha. Those who are going to do archan long time, life after life. Naraji Maharaj speaking. But if you are going to do archan life after life, then you can get the scope to do Harinam, pure Harinam. It is written. Jeno Janma Satair Purvam Vasudeva Samarchitam Tanmukhe Harinama Tishtati Narataha. Automatically you can grow interest for Harinam. Because archan means you have to maintain purity, internal and external purity. Automatically you can go up. And someday if you go on doing this, the Harinam can touch your... This is the procedure. Now, actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur want to give this explanation that any kind of yajna you are going to do, surely there is some matter. You are going to do some fire sacrifice. In that case, you will have to arrange some wooden piece, ghee. You have to arrange, huh? Wooden piece, ghee, mud, everything. Who can say that ghee is not ghee? Fat, who can say? Those ghosts, they are selling ghee. You can watch. Full of, you know, fat. Only little ghee they put off. They are making full of others. Yes, in Gauri Purnima especially. Full, they are selling. So who can say? So... Purity is really very dangerous in Kalika. But what Bhaktivinoda Thakur want to say, the Sriyanu Dibhamya Jigyat Jnana Yoga Parantapaha Sarvana Karvana Khilam Jnane Pari Samapate. Why? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, any yoga you are going to do, you will have to do some survey. Follow, today you are going to attend some function, some jagya going on there, they invite you. Maybe Sankirtan Yoga, who can say? Sankirtan Yoga also, but that song is pure or not, who can say? Some contamination there inside the heart of that we are doing Sankirtan, who can say? So Bhaktivinoda Thakur want to advise us that you will have to make some survey. What kind of benefit you are going to get out of that? Follow you my point. Now, today you are going to participate in this function. You are hearing so many Harikatha, taking prasadam. You are also doing some sankirtan, mixed. Now, you will have to make some survey. If you are very sincere, very careful to sit. Now, today you are going to get some extra power or not, or lose. You have to calculate. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, what is the chit vikas? Chit vikas means what is the spiritual, upliftment. What kind you are getting some inspiration more? Some what you have to do some survey. What extra benefit you are getting? The more in the function, the more the chit vikas means spiritual, these matters, spiritual things. And some expressed, the more, then the yoga is successful. That yoga is successful according to the degree of expression of chit bhava. You are going to attend that function, but your Chit Baba going to go down, then meet big problem. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Vishwanatha Chakravarti speaking, you will have to make some survey and find out that you are going to get some extra facility or going to lose. That is the main point. Because everything depends upon your spiritual consciousness increasing or decreasing. Is increasing? Spiritual consciousness increasing or decreasing? This matter, you have to be very careful about that. Another point, all karma yoga, what you are doing today, karma yoga, those who don't understand, some are there, they are doing karma yoga. Like I can give one example, just I told them, those, you know, Ramanandi Sadhu, they every day giving some prasadam to countless, so many people they are coming. It's one kind of karma yoga. Like, I can give the example of Rantidev. Rantidev, you know, Rantidev? Rantidev Ji Maharaj, he was so merciful that he wanted to get all the, you know, sinful activities on him. Oh, Prabhu, give the result of all those sinful activities of those bonded soul on me. I like to suffer, you know, infinity pure, and please make them free. Please make them free. This is the mood of Rantidev. Rantidev somehow, according to the desire of some, according to the desire of Supreme Lord, by some rishi, he was put into such position that nothing is there. He is almost penniless. He leave kingdom, everything, and going to forest because it was a testing by one rishi. Big testing has sent into. Like Harishchandra, I already told. Ascent. Now nothing is there. All children and wife, everything are fasting for long period. Long period. One day by the desire of Krishna, it is the arrangement of Krishna, getting one plate of prasadam, in which all rice, all sabji, everything there. And one chatu also there. Chatu, no? Huh? Chatu, you don't know? Gram. Gram, you know? Grind the chola. Chola, when dried up and powder, chatu, it's called chatu. So, in chatu was there, sangyav. In Sanskrit, it was sangyav. And java means barley, you know, there's sangyav, or chatu, chola, different kind of, you know, chatu. It's come sangyav. So, also they have some molasses also, gur, molasses, everything there, or water full of a lot, you know, one pot full of water also, everything was served to him. Then in time when he wanted to distribute among children everything, then one, by the desire of Krishna, somebody coming, saying, Rajan, I am very hungry, please give me some prasadam. He was bound to give everything or rice, everything. But some left only, chatu, sangyam. In that case, he is going to distribute among children and take something. In that case, some other people coming, he says, I am very hungry, give me something. Then chatu, everything given to him. Only little bit water was residue. After that, he wanted to drink some water. Follow? In that case, one very vrish, and one you know, very ugly man, is very from low caste, like, you know, in a coal wheel, Santal tribals, some of them come. Rajan, I am very thirsty. Give me some water. After that, the residue water was given to him. Then he is praying to Supreme Lord, O Prabhu, this way I like to serve you, because you are sitting inside the heart of everybody. This way I like to serve you, because you cannot speak it. You cannot speak it because you have no realization that Krishna is everywhere. If you speak, then you are a liar. Rantideva, direct feeling that in every heart, Supreme Lord is sitting inside. Kaya mano bakye udvega na dive. By body, mind and speech, you cannot give pain to anybody. This conception is resting on this single point. Follow? This conception is standing on single point. Kaya mano bakye, I can explain this tomorrow. How people going to take undue advantage of this word and misguiding people? Kaimana Bakhe Kare Udvegna is from Chaitanya Charitamrita. So Kaimana Bakhe by body, speech and mind is prohibited. You have no right to give pain to other jiva. On what point is standing? On a single point. What is that? You should have conception, clear conception, that in every jiva, Bhagavan resting. Inside you, inside dog, inside, you know, birds and beasts, everywhere. Everywhere, Supreme Lord sitting. If you have this kind of conception, then you can get something concrete. Follow? So Arantidev always watching the Supreme Lord sitting inside everybody. So he is praying to Supreme Prabhu, this way, always I like to serve you. Give me scope to serve you this way all the time. Only the thing you will have to do, Prabhu, give me patience. So that I can never lose my patience out of my thirsty attitude. Hungry, I become angry. Patience you will have to do. This much. Now my point is that Jarabharaji Maharaj, I already told you. Jarabharaji Maharaj, while discussing Bhagavatam, I was discussing now how to quote this point, to clarify this point. So, Bharaji Maharaj, leaving everything, which is impossible to leave. All worldly, you know, majestic arrangements. He is a king, great king. He leaving everything, going to forest to do bhajan of Supreme Lord, leaving wives and all property. What to speak about all kingdom, big thing, is a big king, great king. He leaving everything. And he was bound to go to forest to do Hari Bhajan. He started doing bhajan, nice. His bhajan was very nice. Still today you can find the place of bhajan of Bharaji Maharaj in Nepal. In Nepal, Gandaki Nadi. Gandaki Nadi, you know, Gandaki Nadi, where Salagram coming? Kali Gandaki, from there Salagram coming. There was a nice place. Still today if you go and stand for 5 minutes in that place, you can feel some sensation. Still today, if you go alone and sin for 5 minutes, you can feel the sensation there. Very nice place. All around Gandaki, all around, so pure place, you can go mad. There actually, Bharaji Maharaj started doing bhajan very nicely. But after doing bhajan, a long time doing bhajan, he's growing some power also. By austerity, penance, everything doing for heart, because he enough of it regarding property and enjoyment, that king can speak this much, Maharaj, enough of it. But common people cannot see. Those who can say, those who can speak this way, Maharaj, enough of it. I don't like to see an enjoyment. Like Gokarnaji speaking, na? Atmadevji Maharaj is an end point. He is the end point. Atmadev Maharaj is at bay. Critical situation. Now you like to get rescue somehow. Atmadev Ji Maharaj, the father of Gokarna Ji, now really want to get craving demand. Please help me. Now, if you want to put some enjoyment in front of you, no, enough of it. I don't like to get it. When I was a student, very small boy, I was bound to read one, you know, poetry, very nice. Maybe it is written by P.B. Shelley. I forget. P.B. Shelley. Whom they brought her while your warrior death. Whom they brought her their warrior death. One soldier living body there for motherland fighting, body gone. And then a young wife is there. Only one small baby, just baby took birth. Baby is there in room. Whom they brought are warrior dead. When the body is being carried at home, they put the body. When the wife looking, so much shock, even she cannot cry, like stone. Look at the body and become stone. Cannot cry even. Then there was one old Mataji, very old senior. She thinks if she is not going to burst into tear, then there can be some problem. Heart problem, any time, any big problem. Then she was very experienced because she is senior, very senior, old lady. She just go and take the small baby and put into her lap. When the baby was put into her lap, he started crying, bursted into tears. That was a nice technique. Follow? What I mean to say, try to understand what I mean to say. What is the main point? What I mean to say? That Mataji, young Mataji, has been gone. So many cases happening. You can go. Those of family members of your soldiers, they are going to lose. So many. Now what my point is there, what I mean to say, if in front of that Mataji, if you want to give some sweet ball, she like to take sweet ball? If you like to give some enjoyment, she like to get? She like to spit. She become very angry. Less interested. Whole world is dark in front of him. In front of her, the whole world is dark. Blackout. My whole life is blackout. You like to show me enjoyment? Try to get this feeling what I mean to say. You can never forget. This I read when I was a boy only. That time he was feeling, oh, very nice thing. What deep feeling. What kind of painful situation that Mataji was small by, nobody there to take care of that small baby. She is alone. This is the situation of this material world. When Padmanabha Prabhu gone from this material world, I was thinking, oh, Bhagavan, how it is possible? All age is only 46, nothing else. What to do? I am from heart praying for that Padmanabha Prabhu, so that our Gurudev, Prabhupad, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Bhaktiveva, Puri Goswami Maharaj can bestow kipa on that Jivatma. It's painful, really. I cannot see him. I am here. Very painful. So this is the life. This is the condition. This is the condition of this material life, you see. So what I mean to say, that who going to find that I am going to die? Like Parikshit Maharaj. Parikshit Maharaj, 100% sure after 7 days I am going to die. Parikshit Maharaj less interested about any kind of enjoyment. Going to leave everything. Same thing with their mother, everything. So this kind of detachment is quite impossible in this material world. This kind of detachment is quite impossible in this material world. Only and only when you are going to get full kripa of Guru Vaishnav, that kind of detachment is only possible. Like Atmadev Ji Maharaj, now totally detached. Now going to get some solution. That's why actually Gokarna Ji Maharaj speaking, oh Father, all day and night you will have to change the horrible condition, painful condition of this changing world. Pasya nisam jagadidam chanabhango nishtam vairagaragarasiko vavabhakti nishtam. Only advice, the only advice. Oh Father, try to watch. This world is very painful. You know, pasya nisam jagaditam khanabhangunishtam. Khanabhangunishtam, going to, you know, this world, painful. And pasya nisam jagaditam, this world is changing all the time. And vairagya ragasiko bhava bhakti nishtho. Only advice I can give to you, vairagya ragasiko bhava bhakti nishtho. Vairagya ragasiko. Vairagya ragasiko, you like to get detachment Because detachment means attachment unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Detachment without the attraction unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord is dry detachment. That detachment can put you again into misery, a pole of misery. Follow what I mean to say? Is the Siddhanta Prabhupada. Okay, he is going, she is going to and develop detachment. Okay, he is going to develop. But after detachment, what is his duty? After detachment, going to get some attachment to Lord or Guru Vishnu Bhagavan or not? If not, surely is dangerous. He or she can become Mayavadi. So, vairagya-rasiko bhava-bhakti-nishtho. So, it is the advice given. Vairagya-rasiko. Vairagya-rasiko means rasamai vairagya. This vairagya is not dry vairagya. What sarvamvati just told, na? Sarvamvati just told.
Vairagya-vidya-nijabhakti-yoga shikshartamekam-purusho-purano.
Here vairagya is vidya, not avidya. Vidya means vidyavadurjivan, bhakti. You don't try to speak. Try to speak the answer. Try to give the answer. Vairagya vidya. What do you mean by vidya? Already Mahaprabhu said. Vidya means bhakti. Vidyavadurjivanam. Vidyavadurjivanam. So, now point is that this, you know, Jarabharaji Maharaj developing detachment. Surely, Jarabharaji Maharaj was not playing, is developing detachment, very nice. Otherwise, how possible a great king staying there in forest, all around river, in hilly place, nobody there. He don't like to talk with anybody even, like to speak, you know, solitary place, do Brahma bhajan. His bhajan is Ganmark bhajan. Early in the morning, 3 o'clock, getting up and start his bhajan, taking bath in, you know, Kali Gandaki and sitting in very nice place and start bhajan. His detachment is not false detachment, getting some power. But now point is that, someday it was the arrangement of Mayadevi, I told you, na? It's the arrangement of Mayadevi. Mayadevi arranged in such a way, one day, when he is going to take bath in Gandaki Nadi, watching one lion, boom, calling, and one sea deer. She was very afraid. Jump! She thought, backside lion coming to catch me. She jumped, where to go? Backside lion, front side, a hilly river, very sharp river coming. She preferred to jump into river. But river is very current, full of current. You have seen? Never seen. In Rudra Prayag, I've been Deva Prayag, Rudra Prayag. Oh, so dangerous. I've been there. So current. Night time you cannot see. Goom, awaj going on. So, you see, in that case, there are so many big current. So now, when she jump, then the baby coming out of the belly. Inside there was baby. Then baby coming out and fall down into, when jump, baby fall down into water. Mother already heart fell and gone by current. And the small baby just took birth, just one fraction of a second. Going by the current of water, then Jarabharaji Maharaj took the, that was not Jarabharaji, Jarabharaji after. Now King Bharaji Maharaj took decision, I should not allow that small baby to die. I cannot allow this small baby to die, so I can jump into water and catch the baby. I can rescue. They took decision, jump into water, swim, and go catch the baby and come back to Bhajan Kutir. After coming to Bhajan Kutir, what to speak about, chanting, earning everything, because that baby is there. That baby is there, we have to arrange some milk also, because that baby just born, cannot take any fruits and grass. So now it is due to going to village, outside village. Can you give some milk for me? Some baby there. This way, he become busy. He become busy to serve that small, you know, baby. In that case, day by day, that baby growing up, and he become more and more busy with that small baby, growing some attachment for the small baby. If somehow gone to forest, who were gone? Maybe tiger and elephant is crying. This is too much attachment. After that, someday, that baby missing forever. In that case, Balaji Maharaj crying and crying, crying and crying, speaking to sun god, moon god, have you seen where that baby gone? It was my responsibility to give full protection. I am actually traitor. I couldn't give full protection to the baby. Now the baby is missing. You can see, perhaps. You can see because you are up. Could you please tell me where that baby is? This way crying. After that, going to leave body. Jang jang baopi saranam bhavam tajiti ante kalevaram. So, while thinking about that baby, dear living body, he also took birth as dear baby. Some other place, Kalanjar Pradesh. But the memory is there, full memory, like Gajendra. Gajendra, no? Gajendra, full memory there. Hari Bhajan, because the memory is there. Gajendra can remember. That's why he started doing stava. How? Jajapa paramam japyam prag janmanu shikshitam. According to his past bhajan power, he can remember. Now here also, he took birth in a forest. After that, took decision to go to that place, same place. Kaligandaki Nodi, that Bhajan Kuchir, that deer somehow reached that place and started crying and crying. This was my Bhajan Kuchir. I was doing Bhajan. So much detachment I had, but I lose everything simply because of this Maya, 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 Maya. Oh, Maya can come in your life in any form. Be careful, I'm giving here. Maya can come to you in any form. You cannot understand this is Maya. Maya, so powerful. So, reaching that spot, Bhajan Kuchir, only crying and crying in front of Supreme Lord. Oh, I'm giving punishment simply for this reason. I have done some mistake. Oh my God. After that, dear baby, that is missing. Again, when in the form of dear baby you took birth, now going to leave body, last moment, in the water of Kaligandaki. Kaligandaki, you know, in the river, Kaligandaki, very pure nadi, going to leave body. While thinking about the Supreme Lord, what to do? Hey Prabhu, give me chance. After that, he was given a chance to take birth in a Brahmin family. Angiras Prabhara. Angiras. Angira. Angira means Brihaspati. So different in India, different family heritage going on, they have some connection with one or other rishis. Somebody Kasap Rishi, somebody Pulasa Rishi, Vasishta Rishi have some connection. So Brihaspati Angira. Angira. Now, very nice family, Brahmin family, took birth. Now, Balaji Maharaj took decision not to talk with anybody. Like, he wanted to exhibit himself at dump and deep. Cannot speak properly, mad, crazy. He wanted to exhibit himself at crazy, dump and deep. Cannot speak properly. This way. Why? He wanted to give full protection. That is the reason. Full protection. He wanted to take full protection from Maya. Somehow, if I am get again attachment, big problem can be there. So, this way he wanted to exhibit in front of everybody that I am mad, I am actually foolish, I am dumb and deaf, this way. Now point is that, third life, when Balaji Maharaj took birth at Jadbharat, when Balaji Maharaj took birth third time as Jadbharat, that case, in that life, come successful. Now, what do you mean to say regarding that sloka? Sriyana Dipvimaya Jagyat Jnana Yoga Parantapaha. This sloka you already hear. Now, my point is how it is possible that Balaji Maharaj doing bhajan for in the line of Gyan Mark. Balaji Maharaj doing bhajan in Gyan Mark. Whereas that Rantidev doing bhajan is karma mark. But he is successful, but he is not successful. Follow my point, what I say. Bharaji Maharaj, his bhajan is far better, his Ganmark bhajan. But that Rantidev bhajan is karma mark bhajan. But Rantidev is successful, but Bharaji Maharaj not successful. What can be the reason? Whereas we already know, Ganmark bhajan, Gan is sarvana karma, khilam, partho, gami, gane parisamapati. Everything, final conclusion, Gan. If karma mark not going, like Rantidev, surely doing this karma yagga, but out of that he can feel that growing some knowledge, Gan, that Supreme Lord is sitting everywhere. Na? This maturity giving him success. Whereas that Balaji Maharaj doing high-class bhajan was still not successful. Why? Because Balaji Maharaj could not come out successful. Though Ganmark bhajan still could not succeed. Because some maya was there. Somebody asking me, what he should have done? Somebody asking me, Maharaj, what was the duty at that time? When the baby was rescued from water. I cannot allow that baby to die. Okay. But after that, what you mean to say? They're asking me. What he should have done to avoid bondage? I say simply, it was his duty to take the small baby and go to village and hand over that village to somebody or itself in forest. They have their family, na? The deer, they are living in group. There you should live. 2 points. One, you should take that baby and hand over to a village man outside this. Or he could easily take the baby and put in their group, somehow. But, he wanted to take full care of that baby, so gradually, he is losing his bhajan power, everything, concentrated on Maya. Now, the Maya was too strong to avoid. Now, losing everything. Follow my point? There is a point. Now, one very nice point I learned to speak. Very nice Siddhanta. So, how to protect yourself from Maya? I already told many times. Now, those who are taking sannyas or white base like me, brahmachari, for them it is very vital point. Each and every time we'll have to survey that Maya touching me or not. If Maya touching me, I should stop speaking. I should not speak Harikatha. One example of that parrot I told you, na? He is asking Maharaj in Bengali, you speaking, what is the meaning you speak? I say, okay, I can speak there. One nice parrot was there, very nice parrot. And one man, bachelor man, he is staying just near forest. Mane is bungalow, you know, very nice bungalow pattern house. Very nice bungalow, Nothing is there. He is making friendship with that parrot, sometime going outside. Parrot is open, no chain, because it's trained. Parrot is completely chained, trained. And the fruits and everything can have it, can take. But one day, that, you know, that man giving one nice lesson to that parrot. Nice lesson, you know. Whatever you can teach to that parrot, she can repeat. That parrot can repeat. No. It's the capacity of parrot. So that man think it necessary to teach him, because sometimes those are coming, hunter, you know. Hunter coming to catch for a, you know, this and that deer or, you know, birds, they are coming. They are making some trap, network they make and go outside with some nice, you know, fruits and this. Then that man teaching to that parrot, you can speak this way, that hunter can come, can make a network and catch you, and it can take you away from this place. Be careful. In Hindi, in Brajavasi, Brajavasa, in Brajavasa he is teaching that sikari aayego, jal vichayego, unko pakar ke le jayego, sadhan rehna, in Brajavasa. Be careful, hunter can come, make some network and catch you and go away. Be careful. Parrot is actually memorized and every time speaking, hey, hunter can come, can make one network and catch you, go away. All memorized, all the time speaking. Sometimes speaking. But he don't know, but that parrot actually exactly no direct feeling of what he is speaking. What that parrot speaking, no direct feeling. One day really, one, you know, hunter coming made one nice network and giving so nice thing that a bird cannot avoid taking. So lucrative. So that bird is sitting there watching, so nice thing. A network already there, a gone, that man, the hunter is in hiding someplace, and there actually is watching from veranda. So nice thing. I speaking also. Sikari aayego, pakar ke le jayego, all speaking, same thing. Why is it? So nice thing. I must take it, because my master never give me this kind of nice thing. He just jump and fall there and try to take that, you know, that lucrative thing, eating, and already inside net. Already inside, trap inside net. But from net he is, that bird speaking. In net also. He already, that parrot already in net. In network, trap, speaking. Hey, sikari aayego, jal bichayego, tumko pakar ke le jayega. Foolish number one. You are already in trap. You are speaking same thing. You are already in trap. Hey, also, because don't know the meaning, actual meaning, don't know. What is the direct meaning? Same thing. Those who are sannyasi, brahmachari, going to memorize some scriptural analysis, speaking in front of public, no direct realization. Without any direct realization, you have no right to speak anything, because you are already in trap yourself, like that bird. Maya can catch. Be careful, Maya can catch you. Are Maya already catch you? Be careful. Maya is catching everybody. Be careful, giving lecture in front of public. Harikatha. But Maya already catching. He is already in Maya. This kind of lecture is prohibited. You have no right to speak that way. So you see, this kind of lecture should be stopped. So now you see, we go on to go back to the point that actually Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to teach us that ultimately Gyan is more far better than karma. But you will have to realize and understand direct point. What benefit you are going to get? What benefit you are going to get, you will have to calculate. If you cannot calculate, then big problem. Now you can remember, I was discussing so many things yesterday, and also I was speaking that those sadhu, those who are really sadhu, what is the symptom of a real sadhu? Prahlad Maharaj already told. Prahlad Maharaj already told, a sadhu is full of mercy inside heart for everybody, all jivatma. That's why Prahlad Maharaj in front of Nishingade speaking and crying. Prayena deva munayo sabhi mukti kama maunam charanti vijanena parartha nishtha naitana vihaya kipanana vimumuksha eko nanyam tadasya saranam brahmata anupase. Prahlad Maharaj speaking. Oh Prabhu, we find no way out. Prayena deva, usually those who like to do bhajan, they are going outside this society, they are going to stay in forest. Prayena deva munayo sabhi mukti kama. Maunam charanti. Maunam mane? Mauna. They don't like to speak with anybody. In solitary place, they can consider in bhajan all the time. But I am not such a full selfish man. Because a gyani man, those who are going to do solitary bhajan, they cannot deliver other. How they can deliver? They are doing bhajan in solitary place. They are doing bhajan in solitary place. They want to get benefit for their themselves. Prayena deva munayo sabhi mukti kama. Maunam charante vijaneno parathanishtha. He want to get some spiritual development, spiritual benefit, try to do bhajan, get escape out of this material bondage. What speciality there? When those sadhu going to do bhajan in front of everybody, showing his own character, own behavior, etiquette, to put impression into the heart of common people. Follow? That's why Bhaktivinoda was speaking, any amount of your preaching cannot give exact result. Any amount of your preaching can come to failure. Until and unless you are going to change their heart by your etiquette, Vaishnava acharan. If you want to change other people, then first of all, out of your own acharan, you will have to put some stamp into their heart. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking in Sajjantasani. Any amount of your preaching cannot give any result. Because you are going to speak something which you are not going to follow yourself, that Harikatha can go and come back from there, or of the system, outlet. Go inside and go outside. Follow what I say? Go inside and go outside. Cannot stand. Bhaktivinoda Thakur saying, that's why any amount of preaching cannot come out successful. Until and unless you are going to change their heart. Because they are bimukh. Bimukh means averse to Krishna. They never like to do bhajan. If you like to engage them in bhajan, like to save them, first of all, you have to show your idealism. For glowing, firing idealism. You have to represent. You see, my idealism. So if you get inspiration, and come, Mahayano Yeno Gato Sapanta. Now you can follow me. Come, same way I am following. This is a procedure. If you cannot follow same procedure, then you cannot come out successful. That's why, actually, preaching can give result. But Prabhupada speaking, first of all, you will have to represent your idealism, adarsha, glowing idealism in front of everybody, so that they can get inspiration. They can get inspiration. If they are inspired already, they can take it. This way you can change the heart of common people. Otherwise, not possible. So now, actually, yesterday I was speaking, how you can know he is sadhu, he is not sadhu? Krishna, now he, there, the final conclusion of that Vastraharan Lila, somehow completed, but not fully, but still, what to do? Time cannot permit. Now, Bhagavan Sri Krishna is going to give one example. Also, yesterday I told, those who are genuine sadhu, you can go and with full, you know, investigation, you can see, their life is full of seva. They'll never like to enjoy any money, anything coming in their life. But common people cannot do. What Swami Maharaj can do, you cannot do. Any amount of money coming in the life of Swami Maharaj, all use. All use. Even some, you know, of his family member came to take help. Swami Maharaj driving. Go away from Bombay. You think this money is for your help? Out! I say out from here. Throw him out. Is one and single pie is everything. He used to write, he has to publish, he has to go to road, different place. You try to read, you are gossiping, you are taking tea, smoking. You please read this magazine, please. This way taking trouble, road, here and there. So much trouble he took. This way, wanted to save all bonded soul. Not a matter of joke. Everybody can, you know, preach like him. No, I cannot believe. What is possible for him? That is possible for him, not for others. Anyway, what I mean to say, the life of a sadhu is totally dedicated. And another point I forget to speak, why Rantidev was successful, why Jarabharaji was not successful. Try to memorize this point. I forget. The positive point is that Rantidev wanted to see the whole world in connection with the Supreme Lord. Rantidev wanted to watch the whole world in relation to Supreme Lord. He could find Supreme Lord sitting themselves. But the only mistake done by Bharatji Maharaj, that he could not link up this matter. Inside this Harin, Krishna is there, I can hand over this. Failure. Follow. So Bharatji Maharaj could not see the whole world in connection with the Supreme Lord. He failed. He forget to discover Krishna is there inside. This is one kind of Maya. This is one kind of Maya in front of me. Illusion. I should not come in trap. Forget. But Rantidev, any situation, painful situation, always with great patience. Thinking is the arrangement of Krishna. It's the arrangement of Prabhu. So I cannot misunderstand. Prabhu is there inside the heart of that. So he is successful. Follow. So a genuine sadhu, always when looking anybody, he can watch Supreme Lord is there. I can speak one case of Parampuja Kesava Goswami Maharaj. Because usually people think Kesava Goswami is too tough, very angry. But don't know the heart, soft heart of Kesava Goswami Maharaj. One day one boy from Batkulla, here, just at Krishnanagar, one or two station, Batkulla. One boy was driven away from home by their father, mother, useless. He growing some disease, dangerous disease. Impossible. Dhatu, you know? You don't know. Vitals of body gone from body. Those who are brahmachari, they want to maintain this. So he is growing some dangerous disease, useless. All his sleeping cannot move. Almost like paralysis, so useless. Somehow you got information, there is a Devananda Gorimat. I can stay there, take some prasadam there, somehow I have no place to go. He gone there. He is useless. His body is so going to die. Then some brahmachari, he was full of mercy. He's saying, you do one thing. Our Gurudev is there inside Bhajan Kutir. Somehow when he can come out, can watch you, give kipa to you, then you can get cure. You stay here. Here. Beside Bhajan Kutir. He is now Maharaj. Big Maharaj at present is. Big Maharaj means senior Maharaj. Big man, not important Maharaj, means staying in Darshan. Follow. After that, Kesava Goswami Maharaj coming out of Bhajan Kutir, he watching one very painful. What happens to you? Oh, Maharaj, I am going to die if you cannot save me. What happens to you? Maharaj, I have some disease. Maharaj could realize, watching him, this kind of disease. Maharaj said, okay, you stay here. Stay here, we can give prasadam to you. After that, Maharaj started doing homeopathic treatment, proper treatment. After that, he got back his health. Then Maharaj giving Harinam. After Harinam, someday giving Diksha also, red cloth. After that, sannyas. Follow. So merciful. This way, Maharaj wanted to show mercy to everybody. This way, all sadhu. Yesterday, I told one sloka that those river not going to drink their own water. The trees not going to take their own fruits. And clouds not going to take all the crops then fields. This sloka I told you. So, it's very important. Now, Bhagavan Sri Krishna is going to give such a nice example that those trees, they are like sadhu, great sadhu. They never expect, that's why it was written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, na, briksha jano katilo kichuna boloi, sukaiya mahile kare panina mangoi, jai ja mange tare dai apan dhan, gharma vishti sahi anir kare rakshan. It's written, na? Who write? Bhaktivinoda Thakur write. It is a total example of a sadhu. Like tree. More, and in as per Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the third slog, Trinadavi Suni Chana Taravi, is also same meaning. You should get more, you should be more forbearing than a tree. More forbearing. Vrikha jana katilo kichuna boloi. A tree going to give you shelter, going to give you fruits and flowers, leaf, everything, shadow. But a tree in return never want to get anything. A tree have some expectation? No? A tree never going to expect. This way, after giving full kipa to those Ananda Gopu Kumari Kaha, Bhagavan Sri Krishna will be sure because Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving full kipa to them. Not only that, by this slok, I should explain another point. You can remember that I already told the Sukhdev Goswami speaking, Ityadishta Bhagavata Labdha Kamaha Kumari Kaha Dhyantastat Padam Bhujam Krichat Nirvivishur Brajam. Okay. But previous slok, it was written Siddha, one point here. Here. Sadho, this Siddha, Bhagavan wanted to speak. Yata Vala Brajam Siddhya Maema Rangsata Kapaha Jadudisho Bradam Bratamidam Cherur Arjarchanam Sati. Arjarchanam mean? Who is Arjar? Yeah, I couldn't explain that day. I forget. Go to. Because mood was also. Arjarchanam. Because Arja mean Katayani. Bratamidam Cherur Arjarchanam Sati. So here Siddha, this Siddha, Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking, by this word, Jata Vala Vrajam Siddhya, you are all Siddhya. Siddha mean? In your previous life also, you are Siddha. You are not that your Katayani Archan. You are not that your Katayani Archan going to give you Siddhi. This way. Vishwanath Chakudeva speaking, that actually the Siddhi to speak, to give you the total impression, those Nanda Gopa Kumarikaha, they are all Siddha. Siddha. Siddho Siddha. Siddha. Yata Vala Vrajam Siddhya Maema Rangsatam Khapa. I already told explain. So these 2 points very vital. One is Siddha. They are not out of this Katayani Buddha. This is one kind of Prem Vilas. I already told. And Cheru Arjarchanam mean? Arjarchanam mean? Arja ki? Arja? Actually Katayani Devi. When in Brajalila, sometime Radharani or the Gopika speaking Ponnumasi. They are not speaking Ponnumasi. Hey Arja is word. Arjo means Sesto. Arja. This word they are using. When a Ponnumasi has a great, you know, influence, great part to play. Ponnumasi is going to play a great part in this Bhajalila all the time. All the magic spell you are getting, na? All Ponnumasi. Ponnumasi doing everything. So actually, Lalita Sakhi also speaking. Bindadibi also speaking. Bindadibi told, na? Here? I already explained. Bindadibi speaking in front of those Nanda Gopa Kumarikaha that I got one mantra from Ponnumasi. I see your painful situation. I can give this mantra to you because you are interested to get Krishna at your husband. So I can give you this mantra. I got it from Purnamasi. This mantra is very powerful, Siddha. You can go and do a Vrata. You can come outside. You can remember, I told when I started. That time, even Vrindadevi speaking this way. So Arya, they used to speak Arya. Now with full, you know, pleasure, they are with catching the lotus feet of Krishna inside their heart, not dream, it is dhyan, practical. Transcendental object, if you can have the scope to do deep meditation, that object manifests inside your heart. You cannot, what I mean to say, you sir? Suppose Bhakti Pumapurika Sri Maharaj is meditating in Vrindavan. That's mean he already in Vrindavan. Madhavendra Puripa when speaking, Ai Dindyardhanadi Mathuranath Kadabalaka Shahidan Tadaluk Kataran, that means he already passed. He is already in Vrindavan. This is a special facility about transcendental thing. If you have the scope to concentrate 100%, then the object is there inside your heart, in fine form. Like material object I told, na? Matters you like to eliminate, but matter is there. Matter is there inside your mouth to contaminate. Already I told the, you know, speech of those psychiatrists, mind can never go back in. Different kind of matters must be there. You cannot totally back in. It can never go. Mind cannot go. But one thing you can do, replace. Replacement of matters can be there, transcendental matter. Matters must be there. Mind can never go vacant. But you will have to replace it. So what I mean to say, any transcendental object you are going to meditate, then if your meditation is 100% perfect, you are going to get result. This is a commitment speaking by Krishna. Krishna speaking in front of, you know, speaking. Dhyayato. Atmanam api yachati. Dhyayato padakamalani. When Sudama Vipro going to meet Krishna in Dharika, he is very poor. He actually not poor. Actually he is not poor. Who is poor? He is not poor actually. We speak he is poor because he has no money.
Daridro yastva santushto ho kipano tva jitendriyaha.
Who is kipon? Kipon mini? Kipon mean?
Miser.
Nice. Now you are learning Bengali. I am very happy.
Kipano yastva santushto ho.
Mane.
Daridro yastva santushto ho kipano tva jitendriyaha.
Daridro yastu asantushto. Those are not satisfied. Follow what I mean to say. Try to understand. If there is no bhakti, then if there is no satisfaction, then you are daridra, poor. Otherwise, you are not, if you are bhakti, but no money, nothing, you are not poor. There is a special definition given by Krishna in front of Buddha. In front of Buddha. In front of Buddha, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking. Uddhava, who is poor?
Daridro yastva santushto kipano tu ajitendriya.
Daridro is poor, who is not satisfied. Because bhakti is not there. Bhakti is the only object. If you can get bhakti, then satisfaction, saturation can come in your life. Otherwise, you are daridro. You are not doing bhajan of Krishna properly. So you are daridro. I can call you poor. And those who are not having any self-control, I mean no controlling over their sense organ and mind, they kripano to ajitendriya. Kripano to ajitendriya. The kripan. Kripan means miser. They are not going to put their all energy for Krishna seva. Their eyes looking here, their ear, material thing, nose, material thing, tongue, material thing. They are not going to engage all sense organ totally for seva. They are actually miser. Kipanutu ajitendriyo. They have no self-controlling. They have no controlling over their sense organ. So they are kipanutu ajitendriyo. Those who are not jitendriya, they are kipan. Now, what Sudama Vipro, while going to Darika, crying and going, Ha Krishna, Ha Krishna, and speaking, Yasmaratoho Padakamalani Atmanam Mopi Yachati. My friend Krishna is so open heart, so great heart, that if somebody going to concentrate. Even I promise you, if you have the chance to concentrate on the lotus feet of Nityananda Gaur, one fraction of a second, this can also give him great benefit. But totally you cannot do. Mind is so fickle. Can you do? What to speak about hours? What to speak about whole life? Even I speak of 2 minutes or 5 minutes, you think about Maharaj coming, some Italy, this, that coming. Can come. Because fine matters are there. Matters are there in fine form, because you are not out of anartha. You are not out of desire. Try to get victory over your willpower. If you can get victory, those Vaishnavas, they are, why they are so powerful? Why Guru Vaishnavas so powerful? They are willpower. By bhakti. That's why they can transfer power to everybody. But they are full of power station. Guru Vaishnava is power station. They can give power to you also. You can also get your bulb on inside your heart. You see? So, all is power. But that conductor should be okay. Conductor, you know? Current coming, because where is there? Where is conductor? Conductor means current flowing through conductor. If you put one non-conductor, you cannot expect current to flow. Can you flow? Expect? No. So if my heart is non-conductor, passive, how is possible Guru Vaishnava giving kripa? I cannot catch, because my heart is, insulation, non-conductor. So if there is any breakage of any connection, power not coming, so you have to search. There can be some breakage of connection. inside your heart you will have to search. Maybe there is an, you know, disconnection. You have to make reconnection. Again you can find your bulb going. Bulb means spiritual inspiration. You can find full form. Already I told you how you can feel that Guru Vaishnava giving in Kripa, and you can catch it when you can feel, when you can find from morning, very early in the morning, up to night, you are getting enthusiastic mood to do all bhajan. I will have to complete Harinam, I have to do this, I have to do this. When you are getting inspiration, then be sure you are getting Kripa. You are losing energy, oh, I can, oh, so Maharaj speaking, 1 lakh Harinam, not possible, 25, okay. Now I have to take rest. Guru Vaishnava so powerful, why? Whole day they cannot complete Harinam, night time, when you are sleeping, you are sleeping. When you are sleeping, they are doing Harinam. Otherwise they cannot take rest, because how they can give Kripa? If they are not going to obey, then no question of any rest in the life of pure Guru Vaishnava. You see, this way actually, what I mean to say, that this form, actual power, keep a coming. So, if you can concentrate unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan and Guru Vaishnava, I told you, na, one foreign devotee, so many foreign devotees, they asking question in front of Bhaktivala Tithogashi Maharaj, you are busy, where to ask question? Can we ask question to Sam Baba? Oh, yes, sure. They're coming to me, I'm putting so many questions. Madan Gopal was the main of them. Now, first question is, Gurudev Maharaj, while we are doing Harinam, what we should think? I say, see, when you are doing Harinam, You are starting your bhajan. At present, when you are starting your bhajan, first of all, you will have to think, concentrate unto the lotus feet of Gurudev. Why? It is written that actually you have to think about Harinam, Mahamantra, what is the meaning, Radha, Krishna, no. You are new. So now you have no power. You have to concentrate unto the lotus feet of Gurudev. Why? I told already, Guru Charan is a transcendental media, transparent media through which you can see everything. I am not speaking, Popato. I can explain this tomorrow. Guru Charan is the transparent media through which you can see everything as it is. What is what? They are the transcendental world. So first I advise them to concentrate on Guru Charan. Of course, if Sadguru. If not Sadguru is them, you told me, then I, Sadguru. You can concentrate and very shortly you can find, when you are concentrating on Guru Charan, gradually you can find or Param Gurudev, Param Param Gurudev all coming, ultimately you can find the actual Panchatattva, everything. Follow? Because first hand you cannot do. First you will have to go up. So this way I advise them. Now actually Sudama Vipro speaking, Smarataho Padakamalani Atmanam Api Yachati. Oh, my Prabhu is so open-hearted that anybody going to smarataha, if he is going to think about the lotus feet of Krishna, is going to sell himself. Follow, Atmanam Opiyachati, going to sell himself. If somebody is going to consider the lotus feet of Krishna, Gopalji Maharaj, is Gopal going to sell himself in front of that devotee? What to speak about property and this, that, influence? La puja patishtha, name, fame, position, very, very cheap thing. It is written, Atmanam api yachati, Krishna going to sell himself in front of you. If you have the chance, can you concentrate on the lotus feet of Krishna? Fully? You cannot do. Because mind is very chanchal. Cannot do. So, this way actually, those gopikas, you can think this way, Krishna already giving Kripa, okay. And this Lila is very nice, nice Lila. In Bhagavatam, you can find two Rasa Lila. One is Saratkal, autumn, you know, and another is Basantakal. This Lila was done at the bank of Govardhan. And then spring, that Lila, Rasa Lila was at the bank of Jamuna. Two different places. Now, Nanda Gopa Kumari kaha, aptat Sarat Hemant coming? Aptat Sarat what coming? Sarat Hemanto? Shit Vasanto. So, Krishna speaking, very shortly you can get the chance to meet with me, especially in night time, because daytime we cannot fast meeting. So, actually, Krishna promised them. So, after they are fully satisfied, with full hope, 100%, they are going back to home. But one thing, they are going to keep the lotus feet of Krishna at their heart, follow, and they are going back. I mean, if the dhyan, meditation of the lotus feet of Krishna is perfect, then maybe Krishna now gone to covered field, but still Krishna is there with them. Follow what I mean to say? Maybe now Krishna gone to covered field to meet with Balaji Maharaj, Sudham, Siddham, but still Krishna is also there with them. Because they are meditating, I already told. In fine form, Krishna going with them in their respective home. This way, after bestow, you should remember these fine points actually. Even you know, daily life, you have punctual, don't try to cheat. If you are elevated after doing seva, this is the easiest point, you can think. Meditation you cannot break. Those who are great devotees, their walking road here, there, they can see clearly Jagannath. You cannot believe. How possible, Maharaj? You can go to Jagannath Puri, pushing and dashing, you know, by train, go and try to, you know, big, you know, rest there. You can try to see, where is Jagannath? Where is Jagannath? But there's Vaishnav sitting in Rome, they can see everything. Clearly, more clearly than you. Follow. So they are so powerful. Guru Vaishnav can see Jagannath, anything, and Vrindavan there, because their concentration is so high. While they are going to, we have seen in the life of Guru Padma, walking through road, walking train, long ago, still, while going in road, always full concentration. In train also, they are not going to break any rules. Oh, I am in train, how possible to know? In train also, full rules and regulations. Bhajan, Kirtan, everything. Madhav Goswami also. To teach us, even in train, morning time, doing all, morning Kirtan, Krishna, Ita, Chaturmukha, everything. Not that today I am in train, not possible, not that. You heard from Bhakti Vidya Madhav Goswami, Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. Very nice. So this way, they are going, they are respecting whom? Those who respective all those Vraja Kumarikas, they are going to enter their own house with Krishna at their heart. They are not going to let Krishna go away. Atho gopai paribrito bhagavan devukishataha vrindavanagato duram charayana gasahagrajaha. Atho gopai paribritaha bhagavan devukishataha. After that, vrindavanagato, again come back to the same main heart of Vrindavan, where all those coward boys, they are playing. They cannot remember that Krishna was not there for a long time. It is the arrangement of Yogamaya. They cannot remember. Krishna was not there with them. Cannot remember. It is the arrangement of Yogamaya. Otherwise, why Balaji Maharaj speaking? My brother, you look very tired today. You take rest here. I am going for Harding. I can come back and take catch you after. This way. So atho gopai parivrita bhagavan devaki shataha vrindavanagato duram charana gasaha grajaha. Again, Krishna with small, you know, boys, you know, Gopabalak, very small. 2 years, 3 years, very small. Special. With them, Krishna went there to do kripa to those Nanda Gopa Bhujo Kumarikaha. With them, they are coming back and rejoin. Vrindavanagato duram charanaga sahagrajaha. And Gocharan, they are doing Gocharan. Gocharan means they are herding cows in different fields. From Vrindavan, you know, Anantar. From Vrindavan, they are going it long distance. At present, Krishna was there at the bank of Jamuna, na? Because the Lila was the bank of Jamuna. Now, after that, Krishna going far away, interior part, where those, you know, coward boys, they are, you know, playing there, herding cows there. That time, after that they are going more and more into deep forest. After that they are doing more long distance with Balaji Maharaj and coward boys. Now in the meantime, the season I am speaking is, you know, is called Nidharar Kutape Tigme Chayavi Swavi Ratmanaha Ato Patraitano Biksho Drumana aho brajokasaha nidhagar kotapi tigme chayavi shvavi ratmanaha ato patrai tanaviksho drumana aho brajokasaha. There was very sunlight, very hot, very strong sunlight, because now is, I am speaking about this moment, is very strong sunlight. Summer season. Summer season. This is summer season, actually. So hot sunlight, you know. All, you know, surround situation, very painful. Though inside Vrindavan, though it is described here, but in Vrindavan it is actually written, six seasons. Moving around in a whole day. Six seasons. Season six type of now all rotating. It is speciality of Vrindavan. Now in the noontime is summer season. But usually we find each season two months. Huh? Each season, Barsha, 2 months. Gisho. Huh? Gisho. Grisho means? Vaishak Jesto. Asar Savan. Is, you know, rainy season, Sarat, Hemanto, eh? This way one, Hemantukal, eh? This way, Sit, after Sit, Vasantukami, this way, six season all the time, they are moving around, rotating, chain wise. But in Vrindavan specially, six season, you know, rotating in a days. Now we can take the special care, because the, what description is here. Nidhago, nidhago tape, nidhagarka tape, tigme chayavi, swabhiratmanaha, atupatraitana viksho, drumana aho brajokasaha. Krishna in very holy mood, in very nice mood, playing mood, Krishna speaking, you see, we cannot feel. There is strong sunlight, scorchy sunlight. We cannot feel because the trees are there. We are moving, we are, you know, approaching through, you know, in a shadow, as if those trees, they are making umbrella for us. It's like umbrella. We are approaching, we cannot have any sunlight in our body. So strong sunlight. But still we are feeling so nice feeling, you see. So Krishna speaking, so we have the scope to, you know, enjoy this kind of, you know, nice So all trees, they are making umbrella. So now Krishna going to give us one lesson. Atopatrai tana viksho drumana aho brajaukasa. Brajaukasa mane? Brajaukasa mane brajavasi. I mean those coward boys. Brajaukasa. Actually, brajaukasa mean brajavasi. But here, brajaukasa mean all coward boys. He tokstoko Krishna, he angso hishidamano, subalar juno, vishalar sabo, tejasvino, devaprastho barupataha, pasaitano mahabhagano, parartaikanto jivitana, and bato varsato pohimano, sahanto varayantino. All Krishna speaking the name of friends. He stoko Krishna. One name of friend. He Stoko Krishna, He Angso, He Siddhamano, He Subalan, Subal Arjuna, He Vishalar Sabha, He Tejasino, Deva Prastha, Barupataha, Pasitano, Etano, Paso. Look, these trees. Pasitano Mahabhagano, Paraitha, Parartaikanto, Jivitano. You see, as if they are living for others. They are not living for themselves. They are living for others. This is so nice. Aho. Parartai kanta jivitanaha. Why? Palya, any time, but there is strong wind, barsha, when strong rain, you know, torrential rain, when it is hot and cold, always they are giving to, going to give protection to us. Bato barsatapa himano sahanto barayanto no. Barayanto mane? Going to give us protection. So, he stoko Krishna, he angsho he siddhamano, subalarjuno, visalarsava, tejasino, deva prastho, varuthapaha, pasaitano, mahabhagano, parartai kanta jivitano barsa bato barsa tapohimana sahanto varayantano, giving full protection to us. They themselves going to suffer. We cannot compare those trees. They are really sadhu. They are really actual sadhu, because they are going to serve others. They are in expectation, in lieu. In expectation, they are not going in lieu, in return, they are not going to take anything from anybody. So, you see, their mood is very nice. We should learn from trees. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is going to give this example. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving? Why? For this reason. That's why you see, if one rich man going to donate so many donations given, what to speak about Ranthidev, what to speak about Nigoraj. Nigoraj, you know? When Nigoraj got this, you know, body, kikolas, inside this well means kua. Then, finally when Krishna going to catch, touch, and Nigoraj, going to get back his body, then Nigoraj, you know, in front of Nigoraj, Krishna knowing everything. Krishna, it is known, everything known to Krishna. Still Krishna asking, how you get this kind of Kikola's body? But actually point is that perhaps you have gone through the name my name is Nigoraj. Perhaps you have heard. Those who are donation, giving donation, among them my name is topmost. Nigara speaking, if perhaps you have gone through my name, perhaps you heard. My name is Nigaraj, I am topmost your donator. I used to donate so many things. One day I make mistake. It was not my direct mistake. One, you know, cow from one Brahmin house of one Brahmin gone to other Brahmin's house. They fight with each other, they come for solution. I say, Oh, Brahman, I am giving donation, so many cows, I cannot remember which cow I give to whom. Oh, better you don't fight, I can give you, in return, I can give you more thousand cow. I can give. No, I need that cow. A fighting. Finally, without any reason, there is secret reason, one cow was donated double time, maybe, because it was not purposely. Then he got this punishment. Follow. So Nigoraja, if why I speak this point, even if Nigoraja is going to donate, donation, right? One rich man you can meet, he can donate anything. But when anybody going to donate something, he is not going to put himself in trouble. Everybody, follow my point. Like Bali Maharaj. When going to give, donation was not complete, then finally he was going to give his own head. But it's a rare case. Usually in this world, whole universe you can go, even demigods. If you are going to meet you and give some donation, but that donation is not complete donation. Because he is going to preserve something for himself. Follow. I can speak about one nice donation. Very nice donation. Two cases I can speak. When I was doing Chura jungle, Parikram, I was in Churasikros in forest. Someday I reach Kamban. Kamban. I find so many devotees, they are doing Parikram. I say, so many devotees. I say, maybe they are going to speak some Harikatha. Let me hear what they speak. Oh my God. They are doing Kirtan. Different sampradaya. Not Gauriya Sampradaya. I just wanted to watch what they are doing. In the meantime, who is the leader? I mean the Sadhu. Speaking, there is one Brajavasi coming to me. He is going to give donation. He is going to give donation. What donation? What is the excellence of the donation? His name is Garva. His name is Garvar Singh, Garvar Singh, his name. His name is Garvar Singh. In front of me, he giving some donation and crying and speaking unto the lotus feet of Sadhu is my final donation. I have not even one penny left in my life. Final donation. All I had, I give you. Not so big amount, it's maybe 18,000 or 20,000. But that man is very poor man. Very poor man. He collects everything. Another donation I like to speak in front of you from the life of Ramanujacharya. You know? They also, when Gurudev coming, they wanted to do some donation, how to do, because no money is there. Big donation. Wanted to give the life. I can speak these topics after, not now. Whole life, like to sell. He liked to sell his own body for Gurudev. Give me some donation for my body, I can pay you. I can come to you. I cannot speak in details. I can speak another case in the life of Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj, in the Lila. She was from Haryana or Jammu, I think, I forget. I cannot remember. That lady is so poor, so poor. One daughter is there, she is growing up, she thinking how to arrange marriage for my daughter. She is grown up now, no money, nothing. Only one small house is there. Follow, only house, husband gone, left body, left nothing. Somehow they are managing. The small daughter is teaching, getting some remuneration. I mean private tuition, giving something. One day, Madhav Goswami Maharaj going to that place. She is going and crying, Gurudev, you can come to my place to take seva. Gurudev, okay. If I am at all going, I can go to a way, you can maintain. Oh, I can maintain. Madhav Goswami Maharaj, full party. Full party. Madhu Goswami, big party. Madhu Goswami is going. Because that, you know, the lady is poor. But who knows, she is having great, you know, love for Gurudev. She wants to sell everything. She wants to give life even for Gurudev. Who knows what is there inside the heart of a devotee? The Madhu Goswami is going there. Nobody knows. That lady, that Mataji, going to a rich man and going to sell this building, only property. Only property building. And requesting to that rich man, I have one request, painful request. Don't speak it to anybody. I give all my papers, everything to you. I sign, I give all property to you. I need money, cash, liquid money, to serve my Gurudev. And I want to get permission from you. So long my 2 or 3 days my Guru Maharaj is going to stay here in my house for preaching purpose, please permit me. For 2-3 days I can stay. After Guru Maharaj gone, I can leave home. Where you can go? I can go to street. No problem. But I promise you. But don't speak it to anybody. Then I am going to sell my building. See, sell building, taking the liquid money, all money, and spending like king. Like king. Oh, Gurudev. Gurudev satisfied, Madhu Goswami Maharaj. I know you are poor, how are you? She is smiling. Gurudev knowing everything. After Gurudev gone, she is already live back at home, house. This information somehow by the mercy of Nityananda, it gone into the ear of a rich man. His name is Guptaji. Guptaji. I know him. Now he is no more, he live body. Guptaji. A rich man in Jambu. A nephew also and was host for us. When I go there in Jambu for preaching, when sadhu, so with some sadhu, they arrange. But my prasadam was very special. Nobody I don't allow. Specially I arrange. But arrangement was there. His nephew, he is also a rich man. Rajaji, his name. Now he is there. Now when Madhu Goswami Maharaj has gone, in a vacant room, but somehow this nephew, somehow, how it was, you know, that gone to the ear of that Guptaji. Guptaji now not speaking anything, but no, that money was divided into 2 parts. One for the marriage of my daughter, another part already spent for Guruji. Hello, another part is there? But that part is very small part. And another part, most of the, you know, major portion already spent, very small amount. And how we can? Somehow this is gone to by the mercy of Nityananda. He coming from Jambu and rent one big house like king and spent lakhs of money for the marriage of the daughter and arrange nice arrangement for that lady. Whole life you can stay this way, you can manage. Follow. Gurudev knowing everything. By the mercy of Gurudev, maybe he is knowing. Madhu Goswami knowing everything in heart. Madhu Goswami knowing everything, maybe giving some indication to him. So many cases happen. One poor man was there in Delhi. He is Ram. His son is Sam. Ram Babu gone in Delhi. So poor, Delhi 2 bread cannot arrange. He coming and crying in front of Madhu Goswami Maharaj. So poor, always crying. One day, Srila Bhaktivedanta Madhu Goswami Maharaj taking 1 rupee note. Note means a coin. And give me, ja, go. He taking this 1 rupee coin and gone to home. What he can do? Go. He take this coin and put in Lakshmi. And they have their room now, small deity, somehow put there 1 rupee. Not spending that 1 rupees. That 1 rupee is giving that crores of rupees today. So rich, so rich. This way Guru Vaishnava can give everything. But those who are very clever, they never want money, position, rank, anything from Guru Vaishnava. Because no, they can give Krishna. Krishna says, Tomar Krishna. Why should we cheap thing? Guru Maharaj can give me patishtha, big patishtha, you give garland. But if I love, everybody can give garland and wash my feet. He was foolish. Yesterday couldn't give me protection. All devotees coming and jump onto me after Harikatha over. He cannot give me protection. All good touching. Oh my God, somehow I go this way. So this kind of love, puja, padishtha, if we hate in our life, then we can get bhakti. Otherwise, bhakti is rare for us. Now what Krishna wants to speak? Same thing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told. Tinadu Bhusani Chitaru Bhusashna. Same thing, I can compare this point. I can show that rich man, this Guptaji going to donate for that lady, okay, but that is not extreme donation. Extreme donation? Because more property there. Follow what I mean to say. Two, one is, you know, Janak, Videharaj and another, poor friends, Krishna. Same time Krishna divided into two parts. With two sarup, Krishna with Rishimani entering into the house. One is very poor. Nothing, broken room, mud room, and one bagicha, lawn is there. All Krishna entering for a long time, you are expecting my, you know, kripa, so I come. So happy dancing. But Prabhu, I have nothing. What you have, I can take. What do you have? He gone to forest, collecting fruits and everything, and arranging nice pure water for Krishna, on Rishi Manis. Krishna feeling so happy there, taking rest. At the same time, Krishna, another sarup going to Vidyaharaj. He is very rich. Follow? So, when somebody going to give final donation, no? No residue there. Final donation, you know, is final donation. We will have to give you a final donation unto the lotus by Gurudev. Then we can get Krishna. Final donation means only body is there, give body. If you are not going to give your final donation, you cannot expect Krishna. If you are going to reserve something for your backside, impossible. Follow? It is written there. Krishnartha akhila cheshta. So now, this vriksha, all trees, their donation is complete donation. Any rich man, you are going to get donation, they can give, but they are going to preserve something. Even those who are very puffed up, vanity, they can insult you. Insult you, no? If one beggar, sannyasi, going to beg from a rich man, even the guardman, darwan can, hey, go out. They are not going to give any respect to sannyasi. Can give? No. No. Go out. Useless. Coming from begging. Begging, alarm. We have to live on alarm. If not, then I can become a rich sadhu. Rich sadhu, you know? Rich sadhu. Dhoni sadhu. So we will have to habituate. Somebody can insult. I was also, by the order of Guru Maharaj, used to go to Santipur here, there. Begging is not big. Begging is not actually rice begging. This is not main point. Main point, Gurudev send you go for begging. I go. Somewhere somebody, hey, you cannot do work. You are coming for begging. They are insulting me. I am going to some other door. Because begging is the vital point through which you can grow Trinadapi. So many people insulting me. I am speaking something very politely, sometimes not. Coming back. Somebody go, wait. They are giving 10 rupees. amount is not big, but the value is very important, because Guru Maharaj sent me for begging. You will have to practice. You will have to test yourself. You are from this family, you can think begging is derogatory for me. Go for begging. All sunlight, there is no water, no food, begging. One day I enter into one house, there one master coming out and started insulting me. And all disciples there, students there. He started speaking to me, I am supposed going to give 10 rupees to you for donation. What you can give to me? Huh? What you can give to me? You are begging? With politely I am speaking, Master Ji, oh Master, you are giving me donation 10 rupees for not for me, for seva. Be sure I can take and what I can give to me? You are putting question. Now I have one question. You have your old mother, huh, there in the house. How much you have? Is over 80. If you are going to give something to your mother, mother giving some blessing, can you show me how much kg blessing is going to give you? How much kg? All those students, they are laughing. I started speaking in English. So you see, he cannot speak in English, and those students, they started laughing. They could easily discover that man coming to beg is not, beggar, street beggar. I started speaking because I wanted to break his false ego. Straightway I started speaking in English. And he is feeling insulted. He cannot speak in English. All students, they are laughing. I say, right punishment you are not today you are giving. You master, foolish master. What your mother giving? You are expecting, what you can expect from me? You do it to do business? I am sannyasi, I am coming to you. You can give or cannot give. That is up to you. You cannot speak this way. So material you are. I keep listen to him and then go. This way so many cases. Begging is also important. Not that big donation can foreign country cannot make you purify. Siddhama Vibra, to purify yourself, you have to live on alarm. It is not my Siddhanta. I can speak tomorrow. All Guru Bhargava speaking. Rup, Sanatan, who not? You have to live on alarm. Not for Gyastha Vakti, they can lead their life because they are supporting all the time. Anyway, there's some inner meaning. I can explain tomorrow. Today I want to stop here. Etavat janma safalyam dehina miho dehishu pranair arthair dhiya vacha sreva charanam sada. This is the final conclusion I can draw tomorrow. So if you have any question, you can put in front of. So you can remember the sloka by Gokarnaji Maharaj. Whatever sloka I speak, you can remember. Can you remember? Forget. What use? Asar khalu saṃsāra dukṣarūpi bimākaha sutaha kasya dhanam kasya snehubān jalate yanisham pasyāni saṃ jagaditam kṣaṇabhaṅgo niṣṭham vairāga rāga rasiko bhava bhakti niṣṭha Vancha kalpataravasi ke pasindu vaj. Patitanang pavana bhavishnabhyo. So, try to remember, one by one. One question. What question you have, Mataji? You get the about mind, you put question yesterday. I give some answer. So, what question you have? Adhya dhorbe namake.
We have to show our idealism.
Idealism. Genuine idealism. Genuine idealism means your acharan. If I go to explain it, it will take long time. Main point I can speak today, tomorrow I can explain. What is the main idealism? What is the main thing? Not dry idealism. Not dire, my seva mood. My tremendous seva mood is the genuine idealism. If there is not at all any seva mood inside her, I am going to show you dry idealism, that cannot put. Follow my point. Then you can put impression. Otherwise not. Where is secrecy? I am very happy that you put this question. Otherwise I forget to speak. I can discuss tomorrow. Details about this point.